In January 2020, the Ingevity Corporation commissioned an artwork for the three-story stairwell in their new global headquarters in Charleston, South Carolina. Charleston Charted is a 171-inch by 55-inch batik-toned silk depicting the peninsula and surrounding landscapes in bright colors to coordinate with the interior design by local architectural firm LS3P. The batik image is based on maps and charts featuring Ingevity's location. The dyes are applied on top and often from underneath the stretched silk. Divided into grids and drawn with a pencil, I outline the first area to be waxed with a chaunting tool. This Indonesian method allows a heated mixture of 50% beeswax and 50% paraffin to flow out of the copper bowled spout. The heated wax flows like maple syrup and is unforgiving, as there is no way to erase a single drop. The first dye bath is an application of 7 greens depicting land. It takes several days to apply the dyes, and one cannot eliminate misplaced dye. Colors are dark, but they dry lighter. You can see gradations made by mixing dyes. I often refer to the chart for guidance and simply to make a better composition. The dry silk is then waxed to protect the dyes from the next layer of modern fiber reactive Procyon dyes. This ancient resist medium is aided today by electric frying pans rather than open fires to retain a steady 275 degree temperature. Batik is meticulous and complicated. You cannot hurry the process. The special pointed brushes are bamboo and do not fall apart with repeated dipping in the hot wax. The wax chills quickly, so you have to dip the brushes into the pan often to create a consistent flow of wax. The next layer of dyes are red and yellow, representing the marshlands surrounding the peninsula. I enjoy every aspect of batiking, especially the challenge of large-scale site-specific art. This silk did not take the dye well, so it had to be brushed in repeatedly, and this can become tedious. Another waxing allowed me to apply the blues of the waterways. My daughter, Reba, helped keep the dyes wet. The weight of the silk and the wax made the sawhorses topple, and I was glad to have folks there to help prevent an art catastrophe. Last, after this final dyeing, you take it and you iron it. Ironing with a layer of newsprint below and clean newsprint on top, Reba continues to aid me, replacing the wax paper as we move up the batik. The final ironing is directly on the silk. The dyes are heat set and become chemically part of the cloth and take about 5 minutes per square foot. We also iron it from the backside. So it's iron, 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 iron. It takes at least one day, I think for this piece two, to completely iron. After dry cleaning and machine washing, the work is sewn with pockets for the hanging rods. I cannot tell you how much I appreciate my studio staff.